ago, I went very public with my postpartum depression experience. I stood on stage as part of Chicago's 2016 Listen to Your Mother cast and shared what I had worked to hide from those around me, that I suffered from PPD. I admitted to my feelings of uncontrollable rage. I admitted to the sleep deprivation that I had endured. I admitted to my pervasive thoughts of suicide and that I had gone so far as to plan my death around the safety of my children. I even admitted what I believed to be the worst part of my experience, the fact that I knew damn well what was happening to me and that my pride kept me from getting the help that I needed. I feared the reaction of the crowd, total strangers who might deem me a terrible mother and a terrible person. I feared my loved ones' reactions too, because while they knew portions of the shitstorm that had transpired in the months leading up to after following the birth of my son, they also knew how hard I had worked to hide all of this. My change of heart, the change that prompted me to speak up, came after I completed months of therapy and began taking antidepressants. I chose to tell my PPD story because I remember how isolated I felt during my battle. I chose to tell my story to try to help another. I chose to tell my story because I have become a warrior mom and that my pride kept me from getting the help that I needed. I feared the reaction of the crowd, total strangers who might deem me a terrible mother and a terrible person. I feared my loved ones' reactions too, because while they knew portions of the shitstorm that had transpired in the months leading up to after following the birth of my son, they also knew how hard I had worked to hide all of this. My change of heart, the change that prompted me to speak up, came after I completed months of therapy and began taking antidepressants. I chose to tell my PPD story because I remember how isolated I felt during my battle. I chose to tell my story to try to help another. I chose to tell my story because I have become a warrior mom. I stood there then with my truth, as I stand here now with my new truth, the truth that it is possible to live life after PPD. I learned four important things after telling my story. The first is that I will never be cured. I will always consider myself a depressive. Depression is prevalent in my family, and I contended with anxiety and depression issues as a young adult. My children were conceived during a series of years where I was unmedicated and stable. I've chosen to continue to take an antidepressant daily for at least the next few years for my family. There are times when I feel secure with my dosage and my behavior, and there's times when I worry about how I'm controlling things. Depression will remain a part of my experience. The second comes from the first lesson. It is that while I will never be quite the same, I will never allow myself to feel broken again. I know now what I am, a survivor. I'm often asked if I'm thinking about a third baby. Hint, I'm a mom to two boys, and the "do you want a girl?" question is pretty inevitable. I joyfully answer that my family is complete. Some go on to ask if I don't want to have another child because I'm scared of postpartum depression. No, is always my answer. I don't fear reoccurrence of my illness. Rather, I tend to think that I would do a much better job advocating for myself and my mental health the third time around. I've learned to speak up about what I need, and I feel no shame in that. PPD hasn't won this battle. I did. I've also learned that while life is not the same as it was before PPD, it can be sweet. I've been forced into finding the balance between taking care of children and myself. Motherhood is hard, and it's easy to lose yourself as you tend to another person's every need. Honestly, it's hard to plan your next professional move while you're wiping someone's butt. But it's never more vital to remain true to yourself, to allow yourself time, and to chase your passions instead of denying them. It is my responsibility to live my life fully as an example to my children. It's not selfish for mothers to want things beyond successful motherhood, and women need to learn that they can have it all without feeling bad about their choices. The last thing that I learned is the most important. I learned that I'm never alone in my battle with mental illness. None of us are. And I've learned that talking about our experience actually brings us closer together more than apart. I was terrified to tell my story and to talk to people after telling my story. I remember anxiety gripping me as I followed my fellow cast members off the stage. I knew that they were going to be received with hugs and warm wishes, and I wasn't quite sure what lay ahead for me. I truly wasn't prepared for what would be said. There were so many gentle touches on the arm to say thank you, that I did a great job, or that they liked my story. There was more. Hugs from women that I've never met. A thank you from a therapist who said that my story could help others. And a gentle whisper from an older woman who said, "You saved a life today." And there were stories, tons of them. There were stories about women who found me in the lobby or in the bar. Stories about women who endured PPD without treatment. A story about a sister who took her own life while suffering from postpartum depression. These stories, all of them so touching and beautiful, deserve the same voice that mine has given, but will never be spoken again because of the shame associated with them. The moment that had one of the biggest impacts on me was when a young audience member, right around my age, found me near the bathroom. She looked me in the eyes and just said, "Thank you." I knew. She knew. She started crying and said, "I thought I was the only one. Thank you for telling me I wasn't." We held each other, and I promised her that it gets better. I promised her because I'm sure. I thrust my story out of the dark, not fully sure what I was doing. I knew, despite my self-doubt, that it needed to be told. I am no more brave than any person who's ever spoken up before. It takes the same courage to speak your truth to your partner, your family, or your therapist as it does to say it on stage. Each and every conversation we have or story we tell is an act of courage, and I'm humbled to be here today, being brave with you all. Thank you for keeping the conversation going.